episode of The Follow-Up. I'm Eden, and this is my dad, Noah. And every week, for the past 3 years, we've been sitting on my bed and having a conversation about something we want to talk about. And this week, we're going to talk about fourth grade, what I'm thinking going into it. And we've been doing this podcast since kindergarten, and I can't believe that we're still doing this, and I'm going into fourth grade.
Well, you said you wanted to do it in college.
I know.
So we've got some time to go, but we started this during the pandemic in kindergarten. So it was April of 2020, and here we are, September of 2023, going into fourth grade, a school that we live in. If this is your first time watching,
we live in
New York City. Public school. You've been in this school since pre-K, so this is now your sixth year, and you're on the sixth floor of the building. So that's a lot of steps every day. How many steps is that?
So each flight is about 12 to, it ranges, I think, from about 12 to 14 steps.
Well, each flight,
I think it's about 12.
Is 12 landing, 12 floor.
Yeah.
So about 24 between each floor. That's a lot.
Yeah, it's over 100 steps.
That backpack on and your lunch.
It's a little over, I think, 120 steps up to the sixth
floor. When you get to the top, last year you're on the fifth floor?
By the third floor, you're tired.
Yeah, so then you get to the top, you drink water? You should. When you get to the top, drink some water.
No.
It's like climbing Everest every day. Okay. Well, maybe you will this year. Okay, so going into fourth grade, what are you hoping for this year? You can take it any direction you want. Academically, socially, we'll get to everything. What are you hoping for?
I want to start academically.
Okay.
I'm hoping for that fourth grade brings challenges.
Okay.
In each subject, I'm really hoping that I can, for a personal goal even, just to push myself in writing.
Okay.
And give myself challenges.
Okay.
I hope. And
how will you push yourself in writing?
Elaborating.
Okay.
A lot.
Okay.
And kind of thinking about, like, taking my teacher's advice a lot, and then kind of pushing it maybe.
Okay.
I'm really looking forward to reading some new books this year.
Okay.
Because I know we have some good ones.
How do you know?
I know because I was in a fourth grade classroom and I got to see their library.
Oh, so what kind of books did it have?
I noticed there were some mystery that I saw.
Okay.
And I remember some people recommending some books.
Okay. So what are your other hopes?
Hopes
for yourself.
Hopes. Also, not rushing myself.
Well, that's not a hope for yourself.
It's a goal.
These are some goals. Yes, exactly. But yeah, a hope. Okay, so now
and
how about
pushing myself?
How about socially? What are your hopes?
Socially.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that I can this year, if there are some new kids, and try to meet them, and also I don't really usually interact with the other class or other classes,
okay.
So try interact with them.
How can you do that?
If we have sometimes recess, not always hanging out with my group that I usually do.
Okay.
I also hope, to meet new kids and kind of go out of who I usually play with sometimes, and just do other things.
Okay, you hope that you'll be able to do that, which you'll be able to do it. I mean, there's nothing holding you back from doing it. In the past, you've talked about you just hope that kids are just friendlier and also more willing to just all play together and not get into certain arguments.
Oh, yeah.
Is that something that you've thought about and that you're still hopeful for?
Definitely.
Okay.
Just no arguments anymore.
Understandable.
It gives me a headache, and when recess in the beginning of the day and you're not already halfway through school, it's painful.
Yeah. So maybe you can find some new solutions to remove yourself from certain situations or solve arguments or just say, I'm not dealing with this at all this year. And you know, and hopefully that there are other kids who feel the same way.
Yeah.
That just want to have fun or find some kids that you can trust and form good friendships with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So how about some goals in school?
Goals.
In any subject.
Really? Working on my writing.
Okay.
Elaborating.
Yes, you said that. Yeah.
Thinking, like kind of asking questions to myself, because
this
like,
all sounds very familiar.
I know.
Yeah.
It does.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I've been hearing it.
Yeah.
For a while.
Yeah,
but
I think these could be certain things
like
that we
slowing down on my work.
There you go. So that's a goal. It's a goal of yours to try to achieve is just slowing down. So especially in math, things that I used to do when I was a kid, I go too fast, make careless errors, and it's brutal. It's a terrible feeling.
Yeah.
And then slowing down when you're writing and editing and organizing and thinking.
Especially, and also organize myself, like, actually with stuff. Also,
what do you mean? Organize actually with stuff. What is that?
Like, keeping my desk organized, making sure things are neat, no loose papers. Also, keeping my writing organized. Math, if there are multi-steps, keeping that organized. When reading, when I'm jotting or writing notes down, keeping that organized.
Okay, good. And your backpack of, you talk about organized, like cleaning it out multiple times a week, the things
that
you just don't need. And not just shoving papers in there.
That was.
Yeah, right, you cleaned out your backpack today.
Yeah. From last year.
Well, yes, but you went to camp, and there wasn't exactly time, but there was plenty of stuff that we could have thrown out. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So these might be things that we could write. I've been reading things about when you see something all the time, that it stays with you more. So maybe these are things we can write down on your bulletin board at your desk about organize, think, slow down.
Yeah.
Things like that, so that you're seeing that all the time, so it's in your head and becomes part of your routine. Do you think it's going to be a good year?
I do think so. Also because I want to have a positive mindset going into the year.
Good.
And not a negative one.
Good. You can make... I know there are certain things that are out of your control.
Yes.
Especially when you have 33 kids in the class. But you can make the most... And this is a challenge for you that I have for you to make the most out of every day.
Yeah.
That even if your teacher's talking about something that you already know, challenge yourself a little bit. Well, maybe if I added this or did that, you know, to make sure that you're getting the most out of yourself. Because I always want you to feel fulfilled and proud of yourself and accomplished. And the feeling of accomplishment doesn't just come from getting something right.
Right.
You could get a few things incorrect in writing a paper, but you feel proud of yourself because you know you worked hard on it.
Yeah.
I really want to limit the times where you say, I didn't work hard on this, or I know this isn't good, because that's a waste of your time, and also a waste of our time to read it. And then you don't get that feeling of accomplishment. I know that in the past, I think there was one time, I think it was last year, maybe even 2 years ago, you had a writing assignment. You wrote something, and you did it at the playground, and it was something I had said, like, I don't think you should do your
homework
there. I don't think you should do it there.
Oh, yeah,
and you did
that.
It there, and then I said, all right, let me check your homework, and you started to tear up. I think this was 2 years ago. You started to tear up, and you said, I know it's not good. I said, I'm glad that you feel that way. I'm glad that you knew you didn't put everything you had into it, and you were disappointed in what the result was.
Right.
So you don't want to feel that again. So don't cheat yourself.
Right.
Yeah. Don't cheat yourself. Do everything you can to make yourself feel accomplished. And you can't lie to yourself that, I got it right, so I'll feel good about it. Don't lie to yourself. Really don't, or try to trick other people into thinking that, oh yeah, just because I got this right means that, I did it the best that I could.
Right.
Yeah. Those are my hopes for you, that you feel accomplished, and that you feel wow, I really worked hard on this, and you're not cheating yourself.
Yeah.
It's important. Anything else in your mind? I know I just talked for a while, but anything else in your mind for fourth grade? Any concerns?
Not too much.
No?
No, not really.
All right. Well, hope it's a good year.
Yeah.
Nothing else on your mind?
Nope.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Love you.
Love you.